Luck hasn't been on their side much for a year, but many Aussie farmers and growers are beginning to bounce back. And that means months on from the devastating floods, prices on supermarket shelves are starting to drop.
Welcome to Tins and Trays, where in Queensland's Gatton, it's the talk of the town among tourists.
All right, steak sandwich.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
I'd recommend it to anybody that's travelling through Gatton to call in and have a, you know, something to eat or coffee here.
In the century-old Queenslander, everything you see was locally bought and produced. Apart from dishing up delicate treats like this, supporting farmers is key for owner Sophie.
With Tins and Trays, we support locals in that sense of we will use it. I understand their issues, I understand the price. If the price is high, well, that's for a reason, and I just want to support everyone around here as well.
Every little bit helps. Just months ago, all of this was underwater. Growers in Queensland's Lockyer Valley are still bouncing back after withstanding two separate floods. Many are holding out hope they've seen the worst of the wet weather this year.
But nonetheless, it's great to have the rain, and hopefully we have a good season ahead of us post the floods.
Amid relentless rain and countless cleanups, other challenges haven't been few and far between.
For the agricultural industry, there have been some really significant challenges that have come about because of COVID. For example, workers.
Or the lack of. All of this combined has seen prices on supermarket shelves skyrocket. Who can recall lettuce being this expensive? But now, post-flooding, there's relief to the hip pocket.
Farmers are doing as farmers always do in the great state of Queensland. We're managing as best we can.
How long it will last is too hard to tell. Further challenges for an industry so used to overcoming them are always around the corner. Jacob Chigo for 10 News First.